Hey guys, it's an absolute pleasure to be back with you here again. Thanks for checking out this video and practicing with me. Go ahead and roll out your mat if you haven't yet. A lot of times when I'm filming a yoga class, I'm listening to music really loud, but when I edit, all of that is turned off. But I thought you might like to hear that. Welcome to Stronger Yoga. That's Dancing in the Moonlight. That's a happy song. That's a sweet song. Makes me appreciate life. And that's how I felt when I filmed this. I felt a great appreciation for life, and I felt a great appreciation for that number, over 1 million lives lost to this point due to COVID. So you don't have to, but I decided in order to honor them and in order to try to help spread the message that wearing a mask is not a big deal, even when you're working out, I'll be wearing a mask throughout this entire practice. Reach up, breathe in. Exhale, hinge forward. Bending over to place your fingertips on the mat. Then you can go ahead and squat down, lower your butt to your heels, and then bounce around. Swiveling through the hips, drawing the knees to point to the right and to the left. And just sort of swiveling through the balls of your feet. Trying to loosen up all the joints below the waist. Go ahead and place your knees down on the mat. Plant your hands on the top of your mat. And then lift those knees into a plank position. Let's get that first push-up out of the way. Lower your chest all the way down to the mat. Push up and press back. We really want to go all the way to the mat to get full range of motion out of the shoulders. Go ahead and pedal out your feet. And again, move around any way you want. Now straightening that line from your hips to your hands, pressing your heart back towards your feet. Let's go ahead and take those knees down to the mat, pull the hips back, rest your head into child's pose. Now we're going to spring forward. You can leave your knees down or lift them, bend your elbows, touch your chest all the way to the ground, and press back into down dog again. So that's a pattern we're going to repeat. Lift your heels up high, press your heels slowly down, bring your knees softly to your mat. Pull your hips back. Rest your head. Child's pose. Spring forward to plank. Kumbhakasana in Sanskrit. Touch your chest all the way to the ground. Push up. And press back. And we're going to do a couple more of those. And this is going to sort of constitute our Sun A, which is really about flexing joints. It also helps us build heat. Lift up the heels. Press them slowly down. Bring your knees to the mat gently. Draw your hips back to your heels. Lay your chest on your thighs. Come forward to plank. Touch your chest to the mat. Push up and press back. It's always nice getting those first ones out of the way. Everything's a little bit easier after the first one or two. Lift your heels up high. Press your heels down. Lower your knees. Hips back. Rest your head. Child's pose. Come forward to Kumbhakasana, high plank. Exhale, touch your chest to the ground. Push up and press back. Now we've got some momentum. Lift your right leg up. Let's go into a stronger Sun B. I'm going to pause periodically. Reach your right hand up. And you'll know we're pausing because you'll see that little pause sign. Just so you see us twisting, reaching up high with the right hand, stepping left foot forward, top of the mat, lift halfway up. Grab your calves or ankles and pull down. Look at the back of your mat. Rise up. Reach your hands for the ceiling or the sky. Exhale, hinge forward and touch your mat again. Left leg lifts and we step it softly, gently back. We're going to bring the knee down and the chest forward. I'm going to pause again here so we can see we're trying to pull collarbones away from the left knee. And then we're going to sit back to the left heel. Left toes are curled under, right toes pull back. And I'll pause here. So you can see my spine is straight and I'm upright. I'm not trying to lean over my leg. Come forward, plant the hands, step back, touch your chest to the ground, press back into downward facing dog. Left leg lifts. Let's do the other side. Step softly to the top of your space. Reach your left hand up. We're really trying to rotate here, but keep the hips as low as we can. Reach down, step forward, and half lift. Grab your ankles or calves, pull down, look behind you. Rise up and reach up. Straight legs, straight arms. Hinge forward and touch your mat again. Lift your right leg up. Step softly back. Inhale your chest forward, lower the right knee down. And then we're going to pull the hips back. Excuse me. And straighten the left leg. And remember, a straight upright spine as well, pulling left toes back. And then come forward, plant your hands. Step back, touch your chest all the way to the ground, push up and press back. That's our pattern. We're going to repeat that. Lift your right leg up. Step softly forward. Remember, a soft step indicates core control. Reach down, step forward. Half lift, breathe in. And pull down, breathe out. Rise up, spring through the heels. Exhale, hinge forward. And fingertips back to the mat. Lift the left leg. Step softly back. Inhale, chest forward, left knee down. Exhale, pull the hips back. Right leg is straight. Pull the right toes back. Heart is lifting. Come forward. Step back. Touch your chest to the ground. Push up and press back. Now the left leg. Lift the left foot. Step softly to the top. Reach your left hand high. Reach down and step forward. Half lift. Hands on knees or thighs. Exhale, grab the bottom of your legs and pull down. Spring through the heels as you rise up, reach for the sky. Exhale, hinge forward and touch your mat. Right leg lifts and we step it softly back. Always step in soft. Knee down, chest forward, eyes forward. Exhale, pull the hips back. Heart is lifting away from the ground. Inhale, come forward. Exhale, step back. Touch your chest to the ground. Press back into down dog. Let's do one more set. Take that right leg and lift it up high. Exhale, step forward. Inhale, reach your right hand up. Bring your hips down low. A lot of times when we reach up, we lift the butt too. Reach down, step forward, half lift. And pull down and look at the back of your mat. Rise up, reach up. Hinge forward, fingertips back to the mat. Left leg is going to lift and step back. Inhale, left knee down and chest forward. And hips back, sitting to the left heel, straightening the right leg. Come forward, breathe in. Step back, touch your chest to the ground. Push and press, down dog. Left leg lifts. Exhale, step to the top of your mat. Reach your left hand up, keep your hips down low. Reach down, step to the top. Half lift, slide your hands up your legs. Exhale, pull your body to your legs. Rise up, reach your hands in the air, straight arms and legs. Exhale, hinge forward, fingertips touch the mat again, right leg lifts, exhale, step back. Right knee down, chest forward, inhale, eyes forward. Exhale, sit back to the right heel, left leg straight. Inhale, come forward, exhale, step back, touch the chest down. Push and press back into downward facing dog. That is what I call a fantastic start. Take a moment here to collect your breath. We're about to do some balancing cross core. Little challenge here for you. So what I want you to do is slowly slide your right hand back to touch your left leg anywhere from the knee to the ankle. And then as you reach the right hand forward, lift your left leg up. And then, oh, that's tough, that's tricky, it's hard to balance that first one. Plant your left foot, reach your right hand back, touch the toes, the shin, anywhere. Reach your right hand forward, lift your left leg up. I love three, so we're going to do one more. Plant the left foot, reach back with your right hand to touch that left leg. And then hover in your cross balance. Press back. Now that's tremendously taxing for the right hip. So now we're going to bend the right knee, reach back with your left hand and grab your foot and pull your heel to your butt. It feels a little bit like you're just trying to shove your foot in your butt. Okay, so really try to not just capture your foot and be satisfied with that. If you can pull, don't forget to pull. Now press back into downward facing dog. Lift the right leg up and step to the top. Rise up into your high lunge. Anjaneyasana. Reaching your hands above your head. Take a moment to bounce. Find your balance. Now we're going to slide thumbs right over the ears. Wrap the fingers around the skull. And begin to lift the elbows up. Now really work to keep your left heel high and your left leg straight. So press down into the ball of your left foot. Think of your left foot as a shovel going into the ground as you lift those elbows and look up. Make sure you're breathing too. Don't try to hold your breath to hold a pose. Now we're going to lean forward. Plant the left hand. And we're going to come in just to a twist here, just like we practice in our salutation. But now we're going to take it into a stronger twisted triangle. So straighten your right leg. Bend your left knee. Reach up with your right hand. And you see there I magnified my left foot, so you can see I'm really lifting the heel, and also notice my left knee. The left shin is pretty much perpendicular to my mat. Now go ahead and reach down and step to the top of your space. Half lift, pull down and round. Stretch out that back body. Rise up. And let's draw the hands down to the heart and come into a standing half lotus. So take your right foot off the mat. Place the ankle against your left thigh and slowly begin to pull your hips. Imagine somebody had a rope tied around your waist and was pulling you back. So it's not just about how much we can squat on the left knee, or it's not how much we can sit, but how much we can kind of like stick our butt out against our pants. So think about trying to stretch the back of your pants with your butt. And we're going to plant that foot behind us, that right foot, and open up into warrior two. Take a moment here to find the angle of your feet. They should be 90 degrees, pointing away from each other. Reach the hands away from your heart. Take the opportunity to take a few deep breaths and just claim your space. The space around you is yours. Your hands are palm up. Now straighten your left leg and reach up. Pressure in your palms. As you reach your hands back out, bend your knee and your back in warrior two. Straighten your left leg. Reach up. When your palms meet, don't just touch them. Press the palms firmly together. Reach out. Bend your left knee. And let's do one more. You can always count on me doing at least three of just about anything. We're going to rise up one more time because we're going to take this just a little bit further. I want you to pull your left hip to the back of your mat and hands forward. Remember, pressure in your palms, and you're not dropping your right arm on your face. I've magnified that there so you can see neither one of my biceps is touching my ears. Okay? Now come into a reverse. Right arm slides behind your back. Left hand reaches behind you, and then cartwheel your hands to the ground. Step the left foot back, lie all the way down, and now we're going to do a regular little cross-core move here. So reach your hands forward. This is what Superman would do if he was drunk while he was flying, okay? So first press your knees down so your groin lifts. You can see I've got my feet off the mat there. The objective isn't to have your feet off, but just to make sure that your knees press down and your groin lifts. From there, lift your right hand and drive your left heel towards the wall behind you. But what you're trying to do is lift your right arm and left leg without your groin coming to the floor. And then slowly soften and release. Slide your hands back. Pull your belly tight. Push, and then press. Every practice, it doesn't matter where I am, whether I'm filming it or not, my practice helps me be in touch with the feeling of being alive and appreciating my life, appreciating my body for whatever age it is and whatever aches and pains I have or whatever injuries I'm nursing. As you reach your left hand forward, lift your right leg up. and then lower your right foot and reach back with your left hand to touch your leg as low as you can. Reach your left hand forward, lift your right leg up, pulling the chest forward, balancing between the right hand and the left foot. Let's do one more. Plant the right foot, reach the left hand back to touch the right leg, somewhere below the knee if possible. Reach forward and hold it here. And press back. I think I ran out of gas on that other side a little bit. Now lift your left foot, reach back with your right hand, grab your foot. If you can, grab the pinky edge, the outer edge of your foot. It's a better position for your arm. Pull the heel into your butt and release. Just a little release for that left hip flexor. And step forward. We're going to rise up into our high lunge, Anjaneyasana. Biceps line up with the ears. Now lift that back heel high. Don't forget about lifting that back heel. It helps improve range of motion at the hallux joint. It helps us splay the toes. It gives us healthier, stronger feet. And we can't underestimate how important that is. Slide your thumbs over your ears, hold your skull, lift your elbows up. Remember, you're not trying to go back, you're trying to go up. So when you look up at the ceiling, from the ball of your right foot, try to drive your heart to what you're looking at. Now coming forward, we're going to place the right hand down on the mat, reach the left hand up, and then we're going to prepare for a stronger twisted triangle. So as you push back, slide the right hand back as you straighten the left leg. Bend the right knee. Reach the left hand up and then lift that right heel high. Lifting the right heel should feel like you're driving your right knee forward. I think I thought I needed to switch cameras there. So again, lift the heel. Be mindful of the knee. Mindful of the breath. Reach down. Step to the top of the space. Lift halfway up. Fire the back. And then grab the lower legs. Pull down. Round and stretch the back. Rise up. Reach up. And draw the hands down to your chest. We're going to do standing half lotus. We're going to take the left foot off of the mat, cross the ankle to the right thigh, point the left toes, and then slowly notice that I'm pulling my hips back. My chest is going forward, but mostly my hips go back. Whoops! See, if I make a mistake, I try not to edit those out because I want everyone to know that everybody makes mistakes. Everybody falls out of poses. Everybody loses their balance. Doesn't matter how practiced you are. And that's why we practice, just to make progress, to maintain that sharp edge of our practice. Step your left foot all the way back, turning the heel down. Notice I'm mindful. I'm trying not to let that right knee buckle in. Reach your hands away from your heart. Warrior two. Almost every opportunity that I have when I'm in warrior two, I just try to close my eyes and breathe and reach out. Now let's reach up and straighten the left leg. Bend your left knee, reach your hands away from your heart. Coming up, remember, don't just touch the hands, but press them together like you are crushing an egg between your palms. Bend your knee, reach out, warrior two. Inhale, rise up. Pressure in your palms. Bend the knee and reach out. Now we're going to rise up one more time, and we're going to glue the hands together and tilt the pelvis, drawing the fingertips over the top edge of the mat, and with the right foot, pushing the hips away from the top edge of the mat. Remember, biceps should not be touching the ears, so don't drop your head to your right arm or drop your left arm to your face. That's why we press the palms together and lift the palms away from the crown of the head. Reverse. Thank goodness. Never easy when we're working on strengthening the core, but oh, so worth it. Cartwheel the hands, step back. Let's lie down on the belly and pelvis. Slide the hands forward We're going to do cross core on the other side. Remember, we're going to lift limbs contralaterally. That means left arm and right leg. And in the mirror there, you can see I'm pressing down into the knee to keep the groin off the mat. And go ahead and slide your hands back. Try to grip your mat with your fingertips like you were squeezing juice from an orange and then press back into downward facing dog. We're always trying to activate as much muscle fiber as we can find and be as efficient as we can with our practice. Now we're going to swivel the feet so that the toes point to the right side chair. And chair, you know, implies that we're trying to sit. And then lift the right leg. And notice that my left foot there, it's turning slightly forward. It's about at a 45-degree angle. So I can lift the right hand and right leg and balance well on the left hand and left foot. Lift the left leg, step forward. And we're going to work on Warrior Two again just for a moment here. It's going to be our transition to sort of a half moon, but something I really think looks a lot more like a windmill. But first come into triangle. But we're going to deviate slightly from a classic triangle. Reach the right arm forward. You can reach your right hand straight up if that's a little bit taxing for you today. Remember, always be willing to dial the poses down to make them suitable for you. Even dial them up if they're not hard enough. You can make this harder by reaching your left hand forward, palm up. Now, left hand reaches forward. I'm going to slide or step my right foot forward so I don't have to push off of it. I don't want to push myself into balance. I want to float up into balance. So the right leg lifts, the right hand reaches up. The left hand is still reaching forward. Breath is steady and smooth. You can see me rocking on that left ankle there. And that's how balance works. Balance is an action. Go ahead and step to the top of your mat. Reach your hands up into the air. Draw them down to your heart. Now we're going to give ourselves a pretty intense little butt stretch here. So cross left ankle to right thigh. And I'm going to take my hands and run them down my right leg on the inside and outside. I'm reaching down towards my right ankle with both sets of fingers. And the reason why I'm reaching down is so that I can hook my left leg inside my elbows and rise up. Now, really think about pulling. Pull the leg up, but mindfully, right? We're not going to gain anything by tearing our butthole, all right? Plant that foot. Reach your hands up. I guess my point is, don't give up on yourself until you know what the limit is. And wisdom is knowing where that limit is. Step the right foot back, lower the right knee down. We're going to take the right knee right and the left foot left. Bowing, I'm going to bring my elbows to the ground there and then slowly slide the right heel in under my butt. I'm going to reach back with my left hand and I'm going to grab the arch of my foot. Resting the forehead on the forearm and breathing slowly through the nose. Every time I bow and I lower my head too, I have another opportunity to make my pose feel a little bit like a prayer, a little bit of an opportunity to be mindful, like I said, of health or of lack of it, of people that are no longer with us. We're going to lie down on the belly. We're going to do a shoulder roll here. Now we're going to start to put together the pieces of what I guess you could call an apex pose. But we want to make sure that we have that chest open. As I was really thinking throughout this practice about how COVID has had such an impact on people's lives and how many people have lost their lives, I wanted to practice today with the intention of opening the heart. So that left hand behind us as we turn to the right is helping to create space across the chest, across the arm line. Go ahead and roll back to your belly, push up, and press back. Now, we're going to do the other side. So turn your heels to your right. This little side chair that we're going to turn into a side plank helps us when we're standing on one leg. So really, it's a little bit of a cheat for the next pose because we've got our right hand down on the mat. Notice I've spread my fingers nice and wide. My right foot is flat on the mat, spreading left toes, lifting them up high, and trying to get my fingers and toes to touch the ceiling. Go ahead and release that and lift your right leg up and step forward. Rising up again to face the other side of your mat in Warrior Two. And then transitioning to a triangle. Little variation here. Remember, we're going to take that left hand and reach over the head. Keep your left arm straight and keep using your right foot to push your right hip crease where you would put change in your pocket of your jeans. You're using your right foot to push your right hip away from the top of your mat to lengthen your right side body. Now let's transition, reaching right hand over the top edge of the mat. Slide the left foot forward till you can lift it. Remember, we want to float ourselves into balance, not push ourselves into balance. Left hand reaches for the ceiling. And just like when I was in side plank, I'm trying to lift that left foot as high as I can to make my foot compete with my hand to be the first one to touch the ceiling. Just think about lifting, and you're there. Now step that left foot next to your right, and that's me taking a giant breath right there, because that's challenging, and I'm sure you felt that. Cross the right ankle to the left thigh. Now this is when we're going to use our standing half lotus to work deep into a stretch. This pose is essentially like doing a pigeon standing, right? So reaching down and hooking your leg inside of your elbows. I'm having a little trouble there because my phone is attached to my arm. And then pulling the shoulder blades onto your back, lifting your leg, pressing into the left heel, standing upright, breathing slowly, deeply, and trying as best you can to breathe through the nose. Go ahead and release. Rest the ankle back on the thigh so you can withdraw your arms. And plant your right foot. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, hinge forward. Lift the left foot, step back. Lower the left knee down. And now we're going to take the right foot to the right and the left knee to the left. Now, after we lower our heart and maybe we just bend the elbows and get a little closer to the ground, or maybe the elbows will come all the way to the ground. How far down you get is not important. If you can, slide your left foot in under your butt so you can reach back and grab your ankle or the arch of your foot with your right hand. That way you just have that hand hold to hold you down. And you can also, while you're resting your forehead on your wrist or your forearm, you can think about sort of driving your heart forward. It's subtle, but remember, there's energy in every pose. I guess not in Shavasana, but short of that, we're always trying to put energy and intention into the pose. I'll go ahead and step back. Lie down on your belly. We're going to do a shoulder roll, so we're going to reach the right hand out to the right. And we're going to roll onto our right side so the chest faces the left. Now you'll notice there that I didn't bend either one of my knees, even though we will the next time we revisit this position. And that's going to take us to a sort of mild apex today for open heart and always open hips. Always working on those hips, man, because your hips is really the pot of soil for your spine. And the more supple and strong your pelvic floor is and your hips are, the less back pain you're going to experience. Now we're going to push up and press back onto the heels. And then we're going to lean back. look up and pressing into the knees and the top of the feet. Lift your butt off your heels. And then bring the butt back down to the heels. Slide your hands forward. We're going to lie down on the belly again. And we're going to take that shoulder roll just a little bit deeper. Reach your left hand to the left. And roll to your left so that you're seeing to the right of you. Now, what's different about this second pass is we're going to bend the left knee. And it's going to draw forward from here. I'm going to draw the right foot off the ground, drawing the right knee towards my right shoulder. My arm is on the inside of my right knee, and I've grabbed the outside of my right foot. From here, drive through the heel and readjust your grip. You can always grab the big toe, just as I did instead. And on any given day, it's not necessarily important what you're grasping so much as finding the opportunity and the intention in the pose. So by driving through the heel, it's pulling on my right arm, my left arm's pinned behind me, open hips, open heart. I love that pose. Straighten your right leg, slide your left leg under it, roll onto your belly. Let's take it to the other side. Reach your right hand to the right and roll to your right. Legs are straight, but only momentarily. And then, to give ourselves support, we're going to slowly drive the right knee forward. Just slide it up your mat towards your chest. And then lift your left foot. Grab the left foot with your left hand. Notice the elbow's on the inside of the knee. The hand is on the outside of the foot. When you're ready, you've got the right grip, whether it's the foot or the toe, drive through the heel, and then try to pull that foot back a little bit, like you're opening a door. And we are. We're opening a door to the heart, to the hips. We're opening the door in our mind. We're opening the door to compassion. We're opening the door to understanding, acknowledging. I have a friend, he's got a shirt that says 2020 sucks. I'm like, well, 2020 ain't over. Some good shit could happen. You never know. Slide your legs straight and roll back onto your belly. Leave your knees on the mat. Push back. Sit to the heels. Plant the hands behind you. Look up. Lift your butt off your heels. We really want to be mindful. Anytime we bring the hips into flexion, we want to bring them into extension too. We want to always be working on increasing and improving our range of motion. Bending the knees, reach back and grab your feet. And if you can't reach back and grab your feet, you can always lasso your feet with a towel or a strap and then begin to kick. I'm going to give you guys two opportunities to work on your bow. One with the hands on the outside. For those of you who have open shoulders and good rotation through the arm, you can grab the inside of the foot. And that means that my thumbs point up, my palms face out, where blood is drawn out of your arms should also be facing out. Trust me, if you grab your feet incorrectly here, you're not coming up. It's just too difficult. You can't kick. And all I'm doing there is just breathing. That's what's producing that little bit of rocking there. It's not intentionally rocking with muscles. It's just breath. And release it. Take your time coming out of that back bend to work your way back out of extension in the spine. So I'm not going to explode or burst into flames, but I'm being mindful of drawing the hips back. Now go ahead and slide your knees to the top of your mat. And we're going to sit down with the feet separated to slide the hips between the heels. Lie all the way back if you can. And if that's out of reach for you, trust me, that's really normal, okay? So don't be judging yourself by your inability to lay all the way back. You can always just lean back onto your hands. So I'm coming back up so you can see that maybe that's where you are today. And that's a great place to be. If you're on your mat, even if you don't have a mat and you're trying to do some of this on the carpet, you're in a great place. And see, one further step down would be elbows. And then maybe you can slide the elbows out. Take a moment here, wherever you are, if you're still on your hands, and just breathe. The one thing we never want to bring to our practice is judgment or criticism. We want to accept our body, accept our practice for what it is on any given day. Some days we may not have had the best recovery. We may not have gotten a good night's sleep. We may have eaten something that disagreed with our gut biome. And for any number of factors, we may just not feel really strong in our practice, and that's okay. Go ahead and make your way onto your butt. Squeeze your knees together. Let's come into a boat. Reach forward, straighten your legs. If you have to keep a hold of your legs, that's fine. If you need to keep your knees bent, that's fine. We're going to get a little bit more, obviously, with straight legs and a straight spine. I'm trying to lift my heart over my toes as I look at you there through the camera lens. And release. Lie back and plant the feet. Just use the floor that you're lying on as something to stabilize your spine. Then come back up when you're ready. We're going to slide the feet in front of the groin, but we're not crossing ankles. We don't want to cut off blood flow to the feet. Now, I'm showing you this first so that you understand what your options are if we can't go a little bit deeper. So from that Sukhasana position, I'm just going to reach the right hand right and reach the left hand up and over. With your legs a little bit wider at the knees, you might have an opportunity to get a little bit more into lateral flexion. But we don't want to come into this Agni Stambhasana position if we can't rest that right knee on the left foot or rest something between the right knee and the left foot. And then reaching over with the left hand, maybe the right elbow comes to the ground or maybe you're pressing into the right hand. And if you're lengthening through your left side body, you're doing it right. Now lift that knee and plant the foot for seated twist. The heart's tall and proud. It's buoyant. It's floating up. The more we slouch, the more our spine is not going to give us rotation. And then we can take that right knee behind us and twist to the left. I just switched cameras twice there. This is why I'll be glad, just like everybody else, when COVID's over, when somebody else can film this and I don't have to multitask and film myself. Let's do the other side. We're about wrapped up here. So again, notice I've pulled my legs in front of my groin, but I'm not crossing the ankles. I've got good blood flow to the feet, and this is why it's called Sukhasana. It's an easier seated position. Reaching left hand to the left, reach the right hand up. You can always slide or step that left hand out a little bit. And again, I really want to emphasize that any variation of this that you're trying to do in your living room with your body, where you lengthen through the right side body, you're doing it. Now, if you do need more of a challenge, then we want to stack the legs. And notice that now my left knee is stacked on my right ankle. And I'm going to reach over to the left with my right hand. And even though I'm reaching to the left with my right hand, my left elbow is trying to push me back to the right. You can see that expansion underneath my right armpit down to my hip. That's where the juice is. Release. We're going to plant that foot again. That's the left foot now. And that left butt cheek has to be down on the mat. So readjust. And if it's a question of whether or not you can get your left butt cheek on the mat or your left foot on the outside of your knee, remember, you don't have to place your foot on the outside of your knee. You do have that option to have your foot on the other side if it means your glute lifts. And again, you won't burst into flames, but the idea being that if we can anchor the left sitting bone, then both sides of the pelvic floor is grounded, and then the heart can lift because we can push down. Coming into Upavista Konasana, we're just about done here. If you like, maybe you're like, no, I'm already done. I want to take a moment here to thank our Patreon supporters, and I'm hoping that maybe you'll consider becoming a Patreon supporter and helping support these yoga videos. What we want to do is not just practice yoga and stretch and contort, even though that can provide a lot of healthy benefits. Go ahead and lift your butt, look up at the ceiling, drive your hips up into the air by driving your heels down. But if we can infuse our yoga with more strength training, with more functional movement, with better biomechanics, straighten your legs, reach for your feet, and then reach over the toes and pull the toes back. Now looking at the front edge of your mat, pull your heart forward. I hope you'll consider liking this video, subscribing, and hit the notification bell if you'd like to be notified whenever we drop a new video. We really appreciate you guys watching with us. These all these beautiful names. These are the people that have put their wallets on the line to make these videos happen for you. And we'd love your support as well. You can get a Patreon membership to help support these yoga videos for as low as $5. So once you're on your back and resting, take a moment here with your feet wide and your knees together just to internally rotate the femurs, because when we're sitting in a chair, like in your office, typically your feet are together and your knees kind of flop out. So we want to take the opportunity to show our body the opposite. As you stretch out in Shavasana, I hope you'll take the opportunity to reflect on your own life and your health and feel an appreciation for it, even if you have an injury or nursing, even if you have aches or pains. Remember, an achy day on planet Earth is better than being under the ground. For those that we've lost through the pandemic to this point, we miss you all. I've lost a couple of friends to COVID, and I was mindful of them as I laid down here to complete the practice. I really appreciate you guys taking the time to practice with me today. I hope you come back and join me again sooner than later here at Stronger Yoga. Thanks.